Last month, SpaceX launched a Starship rocket for the fifth time. They catch the booster at the first try, and Elon is already talking about going to Mars. But this was just test number 5, and we all know that there is still a lot of work to do. But how much exactly? SpaceX took 10 years from the first Falcon 9 until the 100th flight of that rocket. Will they take as long this time? Starship is 10 times more powerful and massive. But on the other hand, SpaceX has 10 times more employees, resources, and experience than they had back then. It's true that we cannot trust Elon with his timelines, but this is becoming a reality faster than we expected, and we may be closer than we thought to see one of these rockets going to Mars. Even Gwynne Shotwell, the COO of SpaceX, who is usually more conservative, is talking about launching hundreds of Starships during the following years. So let's have a closer look at a realistic timeline and see if, once and for all, Elon has made a reasonable prediction. You may think that a Starship is a completely different project than anything that has been done before. We cannot have a good idea about how long it will take to be fully operational. But the reality is that it's not that different from the Falcon 9 development. Yes, it's much more ambitious, but so was the first recovery of the Falcon booster, and the people working on Starship are the same, so we can use that as reference to have a pretty good idea about the future evolution of this new rocket. In 2012, they launched the Falcon twice, the same as Starship last year, and they increased the launches by 50% during the first years until the 18 launches they did in 2018. That's when SpaceX had around 1,000 employees and they didn't even make any profit. Now, they have more than 15,000 employees and they earn $10 billion of revenue each year, so we can assume that they will progress faster than they did back then. Starship is launching 4 times this year, doubling what they did in 2023. With that in mind, we can speculate about 2 possible scenarios, one more realistic considering that some things can go wrong, and then another one where everything goes right and fast. So let's analyze first the conservative scenario, see how much SpaceX could achieve in just a few years, and how long would they take to launch 100 Starships, and then we can let our imaginations run wild, and dream a little about the optimistic scenario and all the things that they could accomplish, as if we were as bullish as Elon is. There are many estimates about the number of launches that SpaceX will do next year. Even Cathy Luders, the general manager of SpaceX at Starbase, insinuates about launching 25 times, and Gwynne Shotwell says that they could do 400 in the next 4 years. I don't know about that. It seems too much, even for an optimistic person. So let's first have a realistic look at the number of Starship launches in 2025. They have managed to do a turnaround time between flights of little over a month, but these two flights are almost equal, and next year they will be using a new version of the rocket, so something about 6 weeks between flights should be a reasonable approximation. They will also have the second launch tower ready at some point, so considering all of that, we can assume that around 8 to 10 launches in 2025 is something feasible. Then, once they build one or two more towers in Florida and they keep improving the time between flights, they can easily double the launch cadence each year during the next few years, leaving us with something like this, and achieving a rate of 50 Starships per year in 2028. That seems a lot, especially for a conservative scenario, but looking at the progress they have made at Starbase and knowing how SpaceX works, I don't think it's that crazy. So with that estimate in mind, they will launch the 100th Starship by the end of 2028. But what is more interesting is to see what they will do with all these rockets, because they need to launch a lot of Starships for the Artemis missions, they also need to start sending the bigger Starlink satellites into orbit, and let's not forget that they want to send a Starship to Mars by 2026, as Elon has hinted Trump that SpaceX will send something to Mars while he is president. But how many launches will they take to accomplish all of this? For starters, they will need a few more to test the propellant transfer in orbit, something that has never been done before at this scale, but that should not be that difficult compared to all the things that they have already accomplished. They also need to test the Starlink dispenser and start deploying some satellites, and more importantly, they need to recover the ship and start reusing both the ship and the booster. Until then, they will be limited by the time they take to build them, and even going as fast as they can, there is no way to achieve the launch rate they want without full reusability. Just look at the much simpler Falcon 9. They take 3 days to build a second stage with a single engine, they would take weeks to build a full Starship stack. So in this scenario, where they are going to launch around 8 times next year, they will probably use all these launches just to test the propellant transfer, the Starlink satellites, and the recovery of both stages. And by 2026, they will probably start reusing some of the vehicles and also begin to launch propellant for the Artemis missions. Because even though the SpaceX mission is to colonize Mars, they need to prioritize the Artemis missions and the new Starlink satellites before sending anything to the Red Planet, as NASA is already counting on them to do the work and they need the revenue from Starlink to pay for all the Mars ambitions. So considering that they have a lot of tests to do and more urgent missions to launch, with this conservative scenario there is no way they can send a Starship to Mars by 2026, and Elon would fail his prediction once again. But what if this estimate falls short? Could SpaceX realistically launch more Starships in the following years? Let's assume now that everything goes smoothly, without accidents, and that the new Starship version 2 and the new launchpad at Starbase will be much simpler and will allow for rapid turnaround times right away. That would give us a possible scenario where they are launching once a month from the first pad and they have the second pad ready by mid-2025 and launching at full speed by the end of the year. With around 15 launches in 2025 and 30 launches in 2026, that would imply that the 100 Starship would be launched by 2027 and that they would have more than enough rockets to send Starlings, provide the Artemis hardware, and even send a Starship to Mars by 2026. In the previous estimate, they needed to prioritize the Artemis mission and the Starlink satellites, but if they really manage to increase the pace of Starship launches to the next level, they won't need to prioritize and they will be able to send multiple Starship to Mars during the next few years. And it would not only allow for this, but for many other things before the end of this decade. Do you need a replacement for the ISS? No problem. Just adapt the HLS or the Mars Starship and send it to low Earth orbit, and you have a new space station just for a few $100 million. Do you need to send huge satellites into orbit? Starship will be able to do it for a fraction of the cost of any alternative. Do you want to deploy a huge constellation? SpaceX could even use the Starlink platform to send many other satellites, similar to what they are doing with Lockheed Martin and the Starshield program. It's not that crazy to think that they can achieve that. With the Falcon family, they went from 30 launches in 2021 to 61 and 96 the following 2 years, so SpaceX has already proven that they can increase launch at this pace, and with the 2026 and 2028 Mars windows as deadlines, they have enough motivation to go as fast as they can. They just need a few more flights to finish the development of the ship and the booster, but they can do that while testing the propellant transfer and the new Starlink satellites. By this time next year, they could perfectly be offering Starship as an alternative to the Falcon 9 and Heavy, and compared to everything they have already done, what they have ahead should not be that difficult. Remember that they already have a crew vehicle with the Dragon capsule, they already know how to dock two spacecraft in space, and after catching the booster at the first try, there is no remaining task that should take them more than a few tries. Starship may have only flown 5 or 6 times, but SpaceX has already proven that this rocket is not a promise but a reality, and we can start thinking on all the sectors that it will revolutionize. The 100th flight of Starship, it could perfectly be a flight to Mars delivering important cargo to pave the way for future crewed missions, and it will for sure be a reality sooner than we expect. But what do you think? Are all these estimations too optimistic? Or on the other hand, do you think that 25 launches by next year is a real possibility? Leave a comment with your thoughts and subscribe if you want more of this. And as always, take care and learn more.